finishing the whole story, which is irrational. I just said one love, one Africa, as I believe that Africans should love another. I didn't say we should love another in South Africa or in somewhere else. No, I just said we should love another. I don't think there's a problem with that. And second, there is a problem with illegal immigrants in this country. I do know that. Everyone knows that. And we must take action as our government has failed us. Mass deportation is a solution which we must take, because this is our last straw. Yes, I am Pacific African, Sis Natalie, whether you like it or not. I do love my country and I do support it. And I do, and I will, can you please listen? And I will fight it against anything that threatens my country.
What is this?
Listen,
my brother, this is critical. It's a very powerful statement you are making to the world that is listening. You are saying there's a lot of hatred, there's a lot of inzondo, and this is deep accusation. So you have to tell us who is hating who, how, and who is the victim in this hate, so that it's clear, it's not ambiguous. That's number one. And number two, how are you basing that judgment or that conclusion? What is the basis for that conclusion? Because we have to move from a place where we are logical and rational about things. So who is hating who?
Wait, Panama City. His submission is not based on logic. Let me allow him to speak, then I'll come after him. But you are right. It's an illogical submission. But submit, Panama. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Okay, again, you're just listening out of, I don't know what spite you have or anything. I haven't said anything against anyone. I even said this person
no,
is wrong.
No, our submission is based on hate.
No, the thing is, you're jumping into conclusion without even listening. You're listening to the sport, not to learn.
I'm saying submission is based
again,
on hate.
Mr. Pet, may you please be respectful. Can you please have some respect between one another to listen to each other?
Did you hear what I said?
That's what I'm asking.
Did you hear? I'm just responding to you. I'm saying our submission is based on hate. Pure hate.
No, I didn't say who submission speaks with. Didn't say that. I didn't say who hate who. The thing is, you must learn to listen.
Panama, I was getting to my point, but then you don't listen. Panama, I did not say you said anything. I said our submission is based on hate. I'm speaking for us. I did not say you said anything. Yeah. Okay. Listening, it's a skill, but go ahead.
Okay. It's ironic of you to speak of listening. Anyways, as I was saying, is the hatred is Uxolo, again, can you please listen attentively? I said the hatred we have as Africans. I didn't say the hatred South Africans have towards other people.
Okay, so Panama, can you
again,
explain?
Can I please speak?
I'm gonna mute you if you're gonna disrespect me. Wait. Panama, I'm the host. If I open my mouth, that means I'm gonna engage you. I'm not cutting you off. So have some respect as well. Can you explain to us on this panel and the people the hate you're talking about is based on what and how you look at it? Maybe explain to us so that we can understand this hate you're talking about. It's coming from where, directed to where, in Africa? How? Explain in details, because we don't understand. We are lost.
I was trying to explain, but you keep interrupting, then you say you're lost.
Now I'm directing you to where
I
you should
was
direct
going
the
to...
answer.
Okay,
hey, wait, Baba,
I'm going to engage.
He's the moderator. So the he has a right to ask you to reframe your statement. He has a right. He's the moderator.
And they said I should speak. Can I please speak?
Yeah, you answered the question, the hate question.
I'm going to answer the question if you keep quiet.
Yeah, go ahead.
As I was saying is, if you listen to what I said, the hatred between us Africans, the hatred that we have between one another. Tribalism, nationalism, and all of that stuff. I'm not accusing who and who and who and so who of hate.
Okay, Panama. So we don't have we don't have the whole day with you. Try to be exact and straight to the point with your submission. And please tell us why you're telling us about this hate. Carry on.
I can tell you about it. The thing is, it's actually getting annoying. You are so quick to jump on me and attack.
Okay, we're not gonna do this. We don't want to do a semantics.
The reason I'm saying this,
you are a young man, you must listen.
We're not interested in your semantics. We want you to do a submission. I'm gonna take you down. I'm giving you the last chance. If you don't do a submission, I'm taking you down.
This kid is as high as a kite. I'm telling you. He's been saying the same thing for the past 25 minutes. He's as high as a kite.
Make your point.
Because you are just useless.
Relax.
Guys,
you don't want to be honest, you are disingenuous, you are a Pan-Africanist, and at the same time, you are a patriotic. All of that. You can't. You choose one, you stand on one.
Let me speak. You don't have to be radical. You don't have to choose a side.
Well, we have to be radical about speak. Young man, we have to be radical about what's going on in the country.
You don't have to be radical.
Can I ask a question?
May I please make my statement, then you can ask your question, sister.
I'm asking you. Every time I speak, I'm interrupted. The hatred that you're talking about. You came here and talk about the hatred. And this is about South African. It's not about Africans. We don't need illegal migrants. You came here, you said, you made a powerful statement. There's a lot of hatred here. Which hatred is here? We are talking about
the thing is, we wasted 30 minutes on this guy. 30 minutes on this guy.
Wait, guys. Hey, man, I'm gonna take you down, man. Young man, just wait. I'm in charge. I'm gonna put you now on hold. Wait there. Don't talk. Because you're not direct now. Think about how you're gonna do your submission. Look, we don't have the whole day with you. If we ask you direct question, answer them and stop right now.
I was trying to answer.
Keep quiet for now. That's what I'm asking. Just wait for now.
You're not a patriotic at all.
Let's leave the brother. Then we'll come back to you. Morgi, jump. Chime in.
I was just reading online. There's this deal whereby Saudi Arabia they signed with Ethiopia, whereby Saudi Arabia signed like a 50-year land deal, and Saudi Arabia they basically took the most fertile land, Ethiopia, and then they're going to use that land to plant rice and other foods, and then that food, le rice leyo, it's not gonna be for abantu abase Ethiopia. It's going straight to Saudi Arabia because Saudi Arabia is a desert and nothing can grow there. You understand? And then was Australia good to know Ethiopia, we have never been colonized, blah, blah, blah. It's 2024 and these guys are still signing lousy deals. You understand? And then there's going to be more hunger and then these people, what are they going to do? They're going to bus was Alana Mzanzi. And if I figure like Mzanzi was Australia good, hey, we are brothers, blah, blah, blah. I was reading now, ETRC, they signed an oil deal with...
Brother Mogi, I have to just pause you and appreciate you.
Yeah.
For past few hours, you actually one of the people who came and stick to the topic. You actually addressing the issues of the title of the topic of today, the other African countries. But go ahead.
ETRC, they just signed a deal with Russia, I don't know, an oil pipeline deal, and 90% of that money is going to Russia. Russia's going to own 90% of that project, I think, for 30 years. Or 50 years. I mean, DRC gained independence, when was it, like 1958 or in the early 60s, and they're still signing these lousy deals. You understand? And imagine, we sent our soldiers there. We sent our fathers, our uncles and brothers to go and fight in the DRC. Meanwhile, the men from the DRC, Baba Lana, Mzanzi, they are selling drugs and prostitution and kidnapping people. Really, my man. Really. Made a bad decisions and now Zimbabwe is a mess now. And I mean, what business deals, Abumbeki? What did these guys sign? Does anyone know with Abumbeki? What agreements? I mean, you can't have like the whole of Zimbabwe in our country. You go to Zimbabwe now, there's no one there. It's just the president. It's just ZANU-PF. The whole country is in SA. You go to our restaurants. You go to the warehouses. You go all the entry level jobs. It's Zimbabweans. You know, I'm a graduate, so it's where are they gonna get our entry level jobs? Where are we gonna work?
You know, Mogi. You
no, man, this is nonsense, man. I don't want to hear anything about Pan-Africanism. Brothers. I'm tired of that nonsense, man. These people must go. And Emanje, when these people go, we must not spend nothing from our Lavant Club. We must cancel all their IDs. We must cancel all our bank account. We are, in fact, all the CEOs, Lana Mzanzi, that are employing foreigners, they must be arrested for a minimum of 10 years. You understand? You're not going to spend the money to attack deporting these criminals. All of them, they must go. They came here with nothing and they must leave with nothing, man. I'm tired of Lavantaba, man. To hell with Pan-Africanism.
Yes, Mogi, can you hear me, brother?
Yeah.
You know the funniest thing is when they leave Abu DRC. You know how far is DRC?
DRC is far, man.
Jumping our borders to work in the restaurant and turn around and tell black South Africans that, you know what, these jobs are not important. I mean, how do you leave DRC to work in the restaurant and turn around?
The richest country.
No, well, this job is so important that you have to leave DRC. Come on now.
You know, another issue that I have is this issue of BRICS. Okay, I know Guti BRICS, they wanted to be this whole alternative to the dollar and whatever. But if you go to Zambia now, China is teaching people how to eat with chopsticks and how to karate and how to write in Chinese. They are not teaching those people engineering.
They're going to take their
airport. There are certain places where the Zambians themselves are not allowed to go.
They're gonna
China is not teaching these people engineering. They're not doing anything. They're just teaching these people karate and how to eat with chopsticks. Nothing about engineering. Nothing about AI. Nothing about IT. China's here to steal. If people think we'll see BRICS, we are basically building a new monster. You know, if the revolution is to move from America and build a new monster called China, to hell with BRICS, my friend. Because Begamanje, what's happening is that Russia and China are basically arguing which currency must we use. Because yes, they want to move away from the dollar, but now the argument is, hey, I want to use my currency. Russia says, no, I want to use my currency. I mean, what nonsense is that? These guys, they can't even come up with a currency that... why must we use the Chinese currency? Why can't we use our currency? Why can't we, if I'm buying from China, buy with my currency? Why must you use China and why must we build up China to be this monster that's going to take over the planet from USA? I mean, if you go to Chinatown, the Dragon City, you'll not find one single South African working there. It's illegal immigrants earning peanuts. And imagine in China what they're doing. Their prisons are so full. They are releasing all of these criminals. And then the Chinese government is funding them to come and start up Ama Dragon City and all of these things. Those guys are not even paying tax. I mean, really, man, what deals are these people signing? What is the ANC signing? China's not benefiting us. They're killing our industries, man. They're killing this. I mean, I do engineering in the steel industry. China's killing us. The textile industry, really.
I agree.
The textile industry is gone, my brother.
I agree with
you. We can't keep on like this, man.
I agree
BRICS
with
is not benefiting us, guys. We've been part of BRICS for how many years? We are in a trade deficit with China. A massive trade deficit.
Mog, wait. I agree with you on the industries, man. I've seen there's many companies that have shut down because they couldn't keep up with the competition. The Chinese are flushing the market. There we need to do something serious. To compete with the Chinese is something else. I'll bring you back, brother. You back now. Yes, I'm mute, brother Mogi.
I've heard a lot of South Africans say, oh, your healthcare is this, your healthcare is that. There was a time that Arabs were coming to Nigeria for treatment. There was a time we had the best doctors, the best hospitals in Africa, you know, in West Africa. There was a time we had the best education system. The former head of the ICC, I've forgotten her name, a Cameroonian woman. She got her LLB in Nigeria. So there was a time our universities were literally world standard. And obviously, due to bad governance and corruption, those institutions have fallen off. But my point is, Nigerians then could have said, oh, why are you guys all coming to enjoy our education system and our healthcare system and da 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 da. But nothing lasts forever. Now that's changed. So now that South Africa is enjoying some level of stability and good infrastructure, I don't think the attitude should be, oh, you guys just need to go back to your own countries and fix it. I think if we collectively work together and build our nations collectively, and I think Nigeria does a good job in doing that. If you take Dangote, for instance, Dangote has invested heavily in South Africa. He's invested millions, if not billions, in South Africa and trying to, you know, expand his operations to South Africa. So my point is, if we all grow collectively, then there won't just be one hub at any given time where everyone wants to flock to and try and make their money in that country. But yeah, that's my submission.
Thank you, Curated. Thank you so much. Okay, Wendy, go ahead.
Yes, so I wanted to say to Peter, the anger that is South Africans that we have now, it's because we are dealing with this thing firsthand, and it's easy to judge from far because you don't know what we are really dealing with. I do hear what you say you feel, but if you were in our shoes, you will also feel the same way. And I'm still stating my point that we are not fighting against immigration. We are talking about illegal immigration. Because if you do everything legal, then means you are registered. You have the right to be in that country. I hope she got my point.
Yeah, thank you, Wendy. Peace can reply back when it's her turn. Christella.
Hi everyone. I was actually liking and then I actually got on here. I don't know where the conversation started from, but I see where it's going. I think at this point I wanna ask the Nigerians that, are you guys also then acknowledging our cries? Are they valid or are we just making noise? Because it seems like the previous lady who was here the first time before we went off twice, Ginny, she raised valuable points, and unfortunately Papa kept saying that our government should not allow people who are here illegally not to be here. But unfortunately we have Ubuntu. We cannot just chase a child who needs an education away, and at the end of the day we are suffering. So if Nigerians do the right thing, right by their people. We're not saying that people who need to come here should not come here, but do it correctly. I wouldn't mind if the Congolese people were here where there was like a large influx of them, because they are fleeing a war, whether they are not documented or they are documented. But if everyone just wants to come here because of the health system, the education, and just trying to make it big here, it's really, really weighing on us. And unfortunately, as South Africans, our biggest fear is that if anything happens to our country, we don't like going into people's countries. Where are we going to go? We won't, even if Nigeria was like the best country in Africa, we would wanna visit and see how it is, but we wouldn't want to live there permanently. Because if we wanted to, I would also look into applying for jobs overseas, but just the thought of not being here at home, I don't like it. Whether there's better opportunities that side, I don't want it. We love our home. So I hear that we keep on saying stuff, but it feels like you guys are looking for loopholes in what we say and you're not acknowledging our pain.
Thank you, Christella. Oh, if you hear my mum in the background, I'm sorry, guys. Just quickly, there are definitely Nigerians that understand what you are going through. I think it's just a very volatile situation that is happening. Okay.
So, yeah, let me start from the last lady. So she's like, Nigerians really validating their points and their pleas. I think I, as a Nigerian, I understand when you have a problem, you have a group of people who come there and then succeed. However they did it, it could be illegal or legal. It's a problem and you have to notice it. Okay, now my thing is, my take is, if you think that you know a Nigerian that is doing something that is wrong, report them to the authorities. We have what we call in Nigerian neighborhood watch since the insurgents started in Nigeria. You have what is called neighborhood watch, whistleblowers. If you know somebody that is doing this thing, blow whistle. Do you get me? Report them by all means. Some of you, I've heard some people say, oh, we don't want to deport them because it's taxpayers' money they're using deporting them. You want to jail them, life imprisonment, whatever it is you want to do. In the Arab nations, they are doing it. Whatever laws work within that your geopolitical location, you have the jurisdiction to do whatever you want to do with them because it's your country, it's your laws, they should abide by it. So if your law is, oh, when we catch someone with powder or peddling these things, you're caught wanting, you're going to jail, you're going to be jailed for so years, or it's life imprisonment, whatever punishment is there, please apply it to them. Do you understand? We're not saying don't if you see a Nigerian do wrong thing. I don't think I've been in a platform and I've heard any Nigerian say, oh, if you catch any Nigerian found in illegal transaction or caught doing something wrong, don't kill them or please forgive them and all of that. No, I don't think I've heard that personally, and I don't think I advocate for that. I advocate for the fact that if you've caught someone, deal with the person squarely and not generalize and call the name of the country. One person did something, you say, oh, that's a Nigerian, that's how they are. All of them, they're drug peddlers, they're this, they're that. Because I am actually earning an honest living. I've worked for everything I've earned in this life, and I give it to God and my family. So I wouldn't want anyone to point me black. Do you understand? Just because I'm in Nigeria. No. So let us, like, I mean, you guys, it won't be fair if we say you, all of you are drug peddlers or are drug addicts. Do you get? I mean, I hear some people say that, but it's because they are like, it's a boomerang attack. You say these things to Nigerians, there are one people that will not bounce back or will not fight back. So if you've caught them, please report them to the authorities or ask them what your law is there. That's my acknowledgement. That's the way of Nigeria. Who is interrupting me, please? If I have 5 minutes, let me finish and
my acknowledgement is that. Who is interrupting me, please? If I have 5 minutes, let me finish and